Hello friends, my name is Nick, and today we're going to do another online plant shop with me on glasshouseworks.com. I've done a couple of these videos in the past years. They are a very interesting purveyor of online plants. They have a lot to offer, and I really enjoy ordering from them once a year at the beginning of the summer, and it's that time of year, so it's time to sit down and do this order once again. As you will see as we peruse the website, they have a lot of plants. Some of them will be out of stock, some of them will be in stock. They have everything that they have in their inventory on their website, but only what they have available will be in stock. So there will be a lot to see, but only some things that are in stock. They also don't ship the plants very large compared to some other purveyors. So everything I ever ordered from Glass Houseworks has come in a size planter like this right here. This like little 2-inch planter right here, which this is not from Glass Houseworks. This is a plant from Steve's Leaves, which since this is not a sponsored or collaborative video, I'm doing this completely on my own dime. I can tell you that as this is a Steve's Leaves plant, that you can use code Philly Foliage to save 22% on your next purchase from Steve's Leaves throughout the rest of 2022, and I get a small commission from every purchase made with that code. You can also click through the link below. So thank you very much in advance if you do make a purchase. But anyway, this is about Glass Houseworks today. But like I said, once again, just this is completely on my own dime. So I don't want to spend that much money. I don't want to spend more than $100, including shipping, I guess. But we will see. We will assess at the end of this process. But I don't know if there's anything that's going to be catching our mind right here in the front. No. So let's just go ahead and start to peruse the tropical and houseplant selection. Let's click on A. Oh, and I should let you guys know that I am drinking a lovely margarita today. This is a hibiscus and passion fruit margarita. I'll leave the recipe in the description below if you're interested. I feel like I always love to sip on a cocktail while I am doing these little online shopping videos, but this is a very good one. It's a recipe that I've recently been crafting. And how cute is this? Well, I don't want to tip this too forward to the camera or I'm going to spill my drink, but how cute is this little dehydrated lime wedge? Or wheel, it's not a wedge, but between you and me, I actually sat down on my computer to order a dehydrator, like a food dehydrator, because I'm so mesmerized by these dehydrated lime wedges that I got from a local, or one of my friends got me from a local wine shop or a cocktail shop. I don't know how to describe it, but it's a bar store. Let's put it that way. Anyway, I sat down on my computer to look up dehydrators, but I totally got sidetracked, and here we are sitting down filming this online plant shop with me video. So after we're done, I will shop for a dehydrator, but what kind of video would that be? So let's just carry on with this video right here. So in the A selection, I feel like the plants that are coming to my mind that I'm interested A are Aspidistra and Aglaonemas. But we might as well just scroll through. I also really like Aglaomorphas, which is a type of fern, which I've been really into ferns lately. Oh, Adiantums are also a type of fern, but that's something that I'm going to order online. I'd rather buy that in person, as I imagine them not shipping very well, but they're kind of a nice frilly fern. Acmeas right here, or I don't know if that's exactly how you pronounce it, but that's how I say it. That's a type of bromeliad. Aeschynanthus. An Aglaomorpha right here, but it's out of stock. We are entering into the domain of Aglaonemas. I purchased last year in our. Oh, I'm seeing Muffin. Hey, Muffin! I don't know what she's been doing back there. That's the first time I've been seeing her. Hey, Sweet Pea. Oh, she hates when I'm doing work. She will want to be getting my attention probably a lot through this video, but maybe she will be good. Please be good, Sweet Pea. Anyway, I love Aglaonemas. Last year when I filmed this video, Muffin's gonna probably start playing. I got this Aglaonema modestum right here, and I love it. It's actually sitting right here next to me. Why don't I actually show you a Glass Houseworks plant? So it's a decent size. It did still come in the same size planter right here, but this is a decent size plant. I think we would all agree. It's only grown like one leaf, but it's actually an Aglaonema, or like a Chinese evergreen is the common name. So they don't grow very fast. So I will accept that 100%. But Aglaonemas aren't really the hottest plant right now, and I really enjoy collecting them. So I might as well get at least one of them. That's funky enough. This Commutatum picturatum alumina sounds pretty interesting. Also, I should say, I should have mentioned this at the beginning of this video, but I'm going to unbox these plants, of course. They ship kind of on their own terms, in the sense of like everything is like propagate to order in many cases. Not everything, but a lot of the things are propagate to order. So it might take a couple of weeks. There was one time when I ordered from them and everything was in stock last year, for example, where everything shipped immediately. And so I did my unboxing at the end of the video, but I'm assuming that might not be the case this year. So don't count on the unboxing this month. Maybe it probably will be like next month or the month after. We will see how things go, but perhaps you might be surprised. Maybe there is an unboxing at the end of this video, but I would count on it not being for a couple of months. Anyway, this is pretty interesting. This looks like an aglaonema that I've been seeing a couple times out at stores, specialty stores, like plant stores that carry more specialty plants. But this is really interesting. And $18 for a cool aglaonema. It's like all silver. It's kind of like the Philodendron Hostatum silver sword of the aglaonema world. It's got like a slight variegation. So let's try it out. I'll put it in the cart. It is $18 though, which is not expensive in terms of plants in this market, especially for an aglaonema. They tend to be more expensive, but it's a chunk of our budget, let's say. You will see a lot of the things on this website do usually go for just a couple of dollars though. So I might be able to get a decent haul by the end. I would love to try out this aglaonema modestum. Oh, that was weird. Aglaonema modestum variegatum. Out of stock, obviously, but it's just so cool. I really love the modestum, and there's not really a lot of variegated, like standard, like white variegation aglaonemas out there. So it'd be cool to try one day. That's definitely a plant that I would consider to be on my wish list. I ordered this tricolor echo a couple years ago, and my plant definitely looks more like this one in comparison to this. But this looks more like a pictum. Like it's not like a pictum tricolor. You can see it in the background of the picture right here. But the one thing about this website is sometimes they're not necessarily that accurate on their taxonomy, or maybe perhaps they're accidentally pulling the wrong plants. But for example, I have a philodendron right next to me that you've seen probably in a lot of my tour videos. Oops, sorry, just pulled that out of frame a little bit. It was sold to me as a Philodendron Mexicanum, which we will probably see on this website at some point. And it shipped to me, and it's not the plant that's in the photo. In fact, it's a completely different Philodendron, a Philodendron Jerry Horn. Thank you to all of you who helped me identify that. But just one thing, sorry, I'm just kind of scrolling through this website at this point, but I don't really care about alocasias. I know some of you might, but you can just kind of peek through or perhaps pull this website up on your own if you are curious. But let's just speed on through. Alternanthas are more of an outdoor plant, although you will see them offered in a terrarium selection at many houseplant stores. Amorphophallus, you know, that's a fun one that I know a lot of aroid collectors are pretty into. Anthurium, fingerleaf plant, an easy climber with dark... Wait. These two anthuriums right here, they both are giving me, I mean, like, obviously the other one doesn't have a photo, but we'll read the description in a second. I was just, like, speed reading. But anthurium amulum, heterophyllum, fingerleaf plant, easy climbing. I just kind of read this, but fleshy palmate leaves with cute mini green spathe flowers, equally effective weaving itself. Okay, so the thing is, I recently got a Schefflera from Steve's Leaves, the, like, polystichum, and it's so cool, and it's just, like, a Schefflera, and this is giving me totally that vibe, and... That's really cool. Easy houseplant. Sci-fi roots. I know, we're going up to $40. And there's also the digitatum, which I'm assuming the leaves are digitate. Maybe this is one for next year. Have your plant friends declare this to be a Schefflera. Part of me is thinking in my mind that without the photo, I'm not convinced that this might be in their terms the same other Schefflera, but I'm being assured by this photo right here that that's different, or not, I call it a Schefflera, an anthurium. So let's just let's just see this out. But it's $22. Anthuriums have been definitely going down in price lately, but I consider that to be a good deal, especially for one that's not on the market. I have never heard of it before. So I think the goal of today is to try out new plants. Remember here at the Aspidistra, sorry if I get like salt on my face at all when I'm filming this. I got the fun pink salt for my fun pink red margarita. I ordered an Aspidistra from them last year. I ordered the standard Elitier. It's definitely gone up in price. I remember it being like $6 last year. So I've definitely noticed the prices have gone up. So if you do go and watch any of my old online Shop With Me Glass House Works videos, I don't think all of them might be labeled Glass House Works Watch With Me videos on YouTube. Some of them might just be online plant Shop With Me because I think in some of them I've shopped multiple websites. But just something to keep in mind. The prices might be different if you watch the older ones. Now, I've been getting kind of into begonias lately, so I feel like I've never ordered a begonia from Glass House Works. Steve's Leaves, code Philly Foliage, is kind of the reason why I've been getting into begonias. In fact, that plant that I just held up is a begonia. So I'm like, maybe we should try one begonia from Glass House Works if we get nothing else. But you can see here that this is when we're gonna start to see the plants costing that like less amount of money. Is that the phrase? Is that how you put it? These are all just a couple of dollars. I guess some of them kind of go up there to that 15 mark. This is pretty interesting. Let's click on it. Begonia Avalanche. It's like the My Special Angel. That is a great resolution. It looks kind of like the Begonia My Special Angel or Maculato vibes, but I already have My Special Angel. I've grown the other one. This is pretty cool. I like this. Just standard green with that nice like red thing. It's nothing crazy, but for $5, that might be a fun one to try out. I'm gonna throw it in the cart, but that's just, don't quote me on that, you know what I mean? Where were we? We are at Bob Ham. Okay. Cherries and chocolate. Sounds good right now. Convolvol. Convolvolaceae. That is a. That is a name. The grape leaf begonia. I grow one that's already called the grape leaf begonia, so. Back we go. Cubensis. That's cool. That typically means it's from Cuba. Lovely Cuban species. That's pretty cool. I mean, it's just. Is the foliage spectacular? No, but I like plants like that. They're the ones that fit into my home aesthetic. Also, just ignore the mess of plants that's back there because I had to move the plants that are normally sitting right next to me here on my desk so that I can have the camera here. Which, do you love this lighting? I'm lit up. It's not my typical lighting. I'm obviously a little warmly lit right now because I'm lit up by my Soltech Solutions Aspect Light, which you can use code NICK2022 to save 15% on your purchase for a Soltech Solutions Aspect Light, or perhaps, oh my God, was that my ice? That was like a tongue pop. Or their other products on their website, which I do also get a kickback for that, so thank you very much. But I do love it. I really appreciate the warm lighting, although it's not really doing me justice for this video today, but it fits really well compared to other lights in my home, or like the grow light strips that I have that are just like LED lights, and they're not the lighting that I'm looking for to illuminate my home. But I absolutely love this. Moving on down with the begonias. Begonia Earl E. B. That is a name. That's a little robust. I think I'm looking for some smaller begonias. I'm appreciating the small ones. I've had some larger ones in the past when I used to grow begonias out in my courtyard. The name. I don't want to say it out loud because I don't want to get flagged. Pride Month, LOL, hashtag, wait. for the genus Fagus. Wait, I love it though. Like, genuinely, I'm not being an asshole. Like, I genuinely love this plant. It's so cool. That's a cool begonia. But the name! Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness. This begonia is offensive, honey. Wow. Sucks that it's beautiful, but I love it. Begonia glabra? Wait.
Mini grape leaf.
I'm a sucker for this kind of thing. Like, I love anything in the Vitaceae family, which the genus Vitis is grapes. So like Cissus, Tetrastigma, those are two examples of plants I grow in my home that are in the grape family. I also grow Begonia vitifolia, which I'm like, this isn't it, right? Because it looks like a grape leaf plant, but it is not. But this is totally giving me those vibes. But it's just, the leaves look so waxy and it looks very like scandent or vine-like, so. I'm feeling confident. Begonia hillbilly? Why are begonia names so mean? This is neat. This looks like something you eat. Like Swiss chardy. Well, that doesn't look like Swiss chard. This is pretty cool. If I grew begonias outdoors, I would grow this outside because I think it's fun that it looks like very vegetal. But I don't think this would really complement my home. Is that the nice way to put it? I think that's the nicest I can be. Begonias are so cool though. There's just so much variety. It took a long time for me to, it's a cool Listata. It's kind of expensive for their website though. That's really gorgeous though. It took me a while to really get into begonias. I mean, the same way, I feel like I started growing houseplants in 2015. Yeah, 2015. And I would see like peperomia plants, for example, at the houseplant stores. And it took me until I saw a peperomia tetragona, like a couple years in, like 2017, 2018, probably 2017. Not that it really matters, but 2017, and I was like, wait, these are really cool. And then I started to look up more peperomia plants, and then I discovered that the obtusifolias, which I didn't know the plants by name when I would see them, you know, back then, but I would see like the obtusifolias and the clusiifolias everywhere, and I was like, I should try these out, and it really gave me a larger appreciation for them. So I feel like I'm starting to feel that with begonias. Ones I've been getting from Steve's Leaves have really been roping me in, which I don't think we really need to bring home any more begonias at this point because I also did just get a couple from that unboxing that we did recently. This is so different. Once again, will this complement my home? No. But it's a cool begonia. It's just different. I appreciate different plants. I feel like that's the one thing that is different from when I first got into gardening back then. Wincana, question mark? That's the one thing. When I first got into gardening, it was everything by the look. But the more I've been getting into plants, I'm starting to appreciate them, of course, for the look, but for different reasons. Like, I'm not looking for the most beautiful plant out there. Like, I'm looking for things that just complement my aesthetic. Which, to be fair, when I was 20 years old, I didn't really have an aesthetic, so I think that says it all. But this is pretty neat. This is giving me like begonia. This crystal clear picture is giving me begonia venosa vibes, which I wonder if they carry that begonia on here. Which I grow it. I got it from Steve's Leaves, code Philly Foliage. So I am not looking to purchase one, but it's a really cool plant and. I've been seeing it at the Philly Flower Show, which I'm headed there very shortly. I'm going for the preview. I think I will probably be posting this video after the fact. But I'm very much looking forward to it, and I will definitely be doing a little video, whether on here or on TikTok or on Instagram, but I will definitely be doing video footage of at least their competition section, which is very interesting. They do a competition where everybody, well, not everybody, I'm not doing it. I don't know anybody who does it, but some people submit their plants that they grow into, typically people who are involved in like associations or like plant clubs and stuff, submit their plants to be adjudicated, and you get to see those plants, and they always look fabulous, and you get to see plants that you perhaps will add to your wish list. And the Begonia Venosa is one that I would always see the past couple years. And I brought it home once and I killed it. And so I have a second one and it's growing fantastically. Oh my gosh, that's a loud motorcycle or something. Anyway, this caught my eye, Begonia ulmifolia, because ulma something is elm. It's elm leaf looking, which is pretty neat. And it's 425, so let's add it. That's all the begonia we're gonna do. Will I scroll through the rest because we're already at U? Of course! Let's finish out the alphabet. With La Cucci. Why do begonias do this? You know what? It's all the more reason to love begonias. These ridiculous names. I'm like, why do I want it? No. Only one ridiculous name, Begonia. Okay. Bilbergia. Let's not dive into that realm yet. I think bromeliads are for my 30s. Let's put it that way. Wow, at this rate, we've been filming for 25 minutes. I doubt I'm including all of this footage, but we should probably hurry it up if we're only at C. We should consider what genus of plants am I interested in. I don't know. Let's check out. Let's see if they have any. I'm like Calatheas, although. Oh, sorry. I keep pulling this out of frame. I don't think that I'm going to bring home any Calatheas via the mail. Although that's pretty cool, but it's out of stock, so let's not even bother. Okay. So, you know what? We already passed it. We're not going back. You've probably already watched me do that, and you're like, ugh, you passed it. Okay. Anyway, so y'all know I'm super into Peperomia. Let's check out Peperomia. Peleonia. I do enjoy a Peleonia, but I don't think I'm really looking for them right now. Buntingia, the blue. One of my friends purchased this a couple years ago, and she enjoys it. I don't think it's anything. I mean, it's cool. It's cool. But there are hundreds of peperomias out there. They all look kind of similar. Now, this is one that I've always wanted to try, but I've never actually tried it. The Campylotropa. And do I think I'm gonna kill it? Yeah, that's why I've been avoiding bringing it home. But let's try it. If we get any peperomia today, or if we, more so, if we don't get any other peperomia today, let's get the Campylotropa because that is the exact reason to bring it home. Galapagensis, is that means from the Galapagos? I don't think the Galapagos is Galapagos though. World oval leaflets on tumbling grass green stems. Sort of P. galleoli. Galleoli. Why is it so hard to say? Galleoides. Galleoli. Okay, sorry. I need to sip my margarita slower, clearly. Sort of like P. galleoides on steroids. That's cool, which this is P. galleoides right here, just for example, which I do not grow. But on steroids, do we want that? What are we at? $71. We're close. I mean, granted, I don't really feel like making any like wild purchases beyond what we have going on now. I'm like, I need to sip my margarita sour as if I've been drinking a ton of it. I purchased this one before and I'm very interested in growing it because you can't tell me that is not like a peperomia right there. I got the tiniest little plant. The leaf wasn't even like larger than my thumbnail. I'm not exaggerating. It did not make it. And it was like roughly $10. So that was one of the only times I was like, really? Really? But most other times I have gotten my money's worth. In fact, that philodendron that I mentioned earlier, the Mexicanum, that's actually Jerry Horn, has grown up to my ceiling and it's gigantic. And it was minimal in price. We will see what it costs now. But it was like $10, maybe $15 when I purchased it. a bunch of obtusifolias. Sorry that I'm speeding through. But okay, well, that's all the peperomia. So like I said, if I don't get any other peperomia today, sorry, this one, this description, like you don't even need to show me a picture. Oh, must have perfect drainage. We're not going down that road. Okay. Oh, well, we should go back because this is where we're gonna find the philodendrons. Well, the Campylotropa was meant to be. This Anderson's Red. So I've been seeing this on a couple other websites too. One other website, the Ken's Philodendrons website. Have any of you ever purchased from them? I'm like afraid to because the things are like ridiculously expensive, like scary expensive. And I just don't, I love aroids, but I don't care about them that much. You know what I mean? It's like if I had a botanical garden or a greenhouse, let's chat. But here in my home, anyway, it's out of stock possibly August 2018, so you better put that on your calendar. It looks too much like the Philodendron Arubicin's Red Emerald for me to want to actually purchase it to bring it home and realize I just spent $25 on a plant that I already have an abundance of. But I'm curious. This is interesting. I'm not getting it, but it's interesting. Philodendron Andrianum X. So, Soderoy. So I feel like that answers my question because it's like that's spelled incorrectly, but the way that Soderoy, I'm assuming that's how you say it, it's spelled, it always makes me think it's Soderoy, but I think I just got my answer question, my answer. I think I just got my question answered. Bipinnifolium Splash. It's not gonna do it for me, sorry. The thing is, Splash on a Hoya, Splash on a Philodendron, virus. That's what it looks like to me. Sorry. This one's fun. I have this one in my home, and I bought it a couple years ago. It was only $5. Not that $15 is not worth it, because I would have paid $20 for the plant that I got. I think it is a fantastic Philodendron. There is no but. I love it. Well, the but is, I don't know if it's actually Philodendron domesticum just because they're plants. The taxonomy, the names can sometimes be off, but I love it. It looks great. I've purchased this one in the past. It was $10 when I bought it. I really enjoy it. It hasn't grown that much. I think of it more as a radiatum, though. It says Elegans dubium radium. But I think it's a radiatum. I could be wrong. I've also purchased this a couple times. Price has gone up. But it's still worth it. 100%. Although I feel like this is a, I think, Tripartitum. I think you can get it on a couple other websites for a decent price at this point. I think that's a philodendron that... I love the foliage. But I don't think the masses love the foliage. It's kind of plain. So I don't think it's one that's really... garners a high price. And it's pretty interesting that they have this in stock right now. I'm sure many people will be interested in this. I feel like $85 is a good price, keeping in mind the pot size and the plant's not, probably not going to be that big. But that seems to be a pretty good price, but it's just not a plant that I'm interested in getting. Gloriosum. Must have very high humidity. I don't have very high humidity with mine. It does fine. It does great. This is cool. You know, I wanted this one last year and I totally took it out of the cart. So let's put it in the cart. $79.50 though. Well, what did I say? $100. And we have 9 items in there. That's a lot. I can totally ditch like one or two of the begonias too if we find something else. Okay, so the Mexicanum. I got this. Oh, see, it's like so frustrating. It's not like I love my Jerry Horn. If anybody here from Glass House is watching, I love my Jerry Horn. But you got the photo here with the purple on the back of the leaves, which this is a photo of a real Mexicanum. But you sent me a Jerry Horn. You don't need to make up for it too. I love my Jerry Horn, but I'm just like, you should get what you pay for. I think we could all agree on that. But Like, that's what I was kind of saying. Like, I'm purchasing from this. This is what, the fourth year in a row that I'm buying from Glass Houseworks. Like, I very much enjoy purchasing from them. I think the fact that sometimes you don't really get what you're expecting is kind of half of the fun. And on top of that, they always send you something extra, whether it's something good. Like, I feel like I don't normally end up keeping the extra stuff. I normally give it to my friends. But sometimes they give you something fun, but obviously if it's extra stuff, they're usually probably just getting rid of it. So you can do the math. Anyway, it's nice to see that they have a bunch of these things in stock. They do have this Mexicanum in stock if you want to take the gamble, which honestly, $45 for a Jerry Horn or a Mexicanum, that's a good deal. In today's climate, that's absolutely a good deal. But that's probably going to end the fold. And I feel like this is like my ultimate wish list philodendron. They have this growing at Longwood Gardens. It's just so cool. But that's a local botanical garden to me. Let's check out the Hoyas. We might wrap it up there. I just feel like this video has been long enough. But we could consolidate for some Hoyas. Well, this is something right here. Hoya carnosa dappled gray. I think I actually technically grow this already, so I'm not gonna get it, but that's is that do people like that? I don't know. I think the gray ghost is obviously the one that I'm kind of mistaking this for, but dapple gray. I don't grow a gray ghost. I think I do grow this dapple gray one though, I think. Kimengiana. I really enjoy Kimengiana. Fun. We're gonna have to consolidate. Because I got a fungi, I don't know, a couple years ago, maybe like 2 years ago. I just threw it out recently. Now, the issue, like, am I getting myself into this again now? Like, I don't wanna. I feel like I'm being a little harsh in some ways towards this website, which I cannot drive home the point enough that I thoroughly enjoy getting stuff from Glass Houseworks. But the fungi that I had this some sort of scale on it, like a very particular kind of scale. And I just don't know if I want to sign myself up for it again. Like, I don't know if I'm spending $18 on like a scale-infested Hoya. But I really want to grow a Hoya fungi. So let's try it. Let's try it. Let's try it. Let's do it. We'll just clean it very heavily when it comes in, and probably again for a month or two. But that, I don't know. I feel like we should probably wrap it up there. Let's just scroll through. Yeah, that's it. So let's look at our cart. 9750. Can we access my shopping cart? Okay, here we go. Tip, click on shopping cart. Or maybe you can click on the cart. No, you can't. Anyway. So let's see. I want the Aglaonema. I want the Anthurium. Those two are the must-haves. I'm gonna get rid of the Bobham. I feel like this is pronounced like phagifolia, although we all are thinking the same thing, obviously. I think it's really cool. Like, all jokes aside, I'm pretty interested by this. However, I feel like it does look very similar to this Begonia globula. Is this the same photo? Wait. Investigation. No. See, I really like the way this looks. It reminds me of a Paleonia. And I want them both. Well, we don't need this begonia because, or I'm sorry, peperomia. Like, do I really need this many begonias in my collection? So, Aglaonema, Anthurium, begonia, 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 peperomia, philodendron, Hoya. Like, we got good stuff going on here. Let's estimate the shipping. So the shipping is estimated to be $33, which honestly makes sense. But I just don't want to spend that much money. So I just feel like if we remove like maybe one or two plants, we'll be in a much more palatable range for what I was saying, which is not too far off. It's like $20 off what our budget was supposed to be. But I just feel like we'll take one plant off and the shipping will probably go down a couple dollars and we'll take another plant. Oh, sorry about that. We'll take another plant off and then it'll probably go down a couple more. So let's consolidate on the begonias. Oh, God. You know what? It's Pride Month. Let's get rid of the one that's like remotely offensive. All right, it went down $2. Okay, which begonia? Which begonia do we want? Let's get the grape leaf. We like those. Okay, one more time. Consolidating. Okay, so we got down not very much more. It's $29, which, like I said, that makes sense. I understand. So we're gonna order this. Aglaonema. That's fun. I'm excited about the Aglaonema. I'm excited about the Anthurium, the Begonia. I'm excited to try this plain. I like plain plants. If I ever call something plain, that's a compliment. This plain begonia, this peperomia, I'm probably gonna kill, but I have to try it. It's been so long, and I haven't tried this like doppelganger to a Pilea peperomioides peperomia. This philodendron incunsinum, which looks plain as well, compliment. Gotta try it. And then we're splurge. I'm calling it a splurge because I don't know if we're actually going to end up with growing healthy plant in the end. But we're going to try out this Hoya fungi because let's do it. I'm going to go ahead and order these. We will unbox them when they come, which will probably not be for a couple of weeks, if not a month or two, as I believe they have like a 4 to 10 week periods that they tend to ship on. Like I said, I have had them ship earlier than that, but most often it does take at least a month before I get that shipping notification that my plants are on the way. So we'll be patient. That's part of the process of ordering from this website, but I always enjoy it. Like I said, I've been doing it for a couple years now, so I'm looking forward to seeing these plants when they do make their way over here. So thank you guys so much for joining me. If you don't already, you can follow me on TikTok and Instagram at Philly Foliage. You can subscribe to my Patreon for even more houseplant content. You can subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys in my next video. Have a great day.